G'day there, Jake from Snowy's. Today I'm going to show you the Cedar Summit Stretch-Loc Strap. These straps are easy to use, they're super versatile with lots of adjustment, and they are super secure, and they're made from really strong TPU material. So the Cedar Summit Stretch-Loc Straps come in a variety of sizes. You've got the 20mm wide strap here, and a smaller 12mm wide strap here, and they come in a variety of lengths from 300mm right through to 750mm. They come in a couple of colors as well, and they're made from super strong materials. You've got TPU on the strap here, and the buckle is a strengthened polyurethane. Now the polyurethane has a little bit of flex in it, so that it won't break under pressure. It's really, really strong, and it's designed to flex. The TPU here is really strong. I can't break that by pulling that super tight like that, and it's designed to hold loads under pressure. Now there's a few cool unique features with this. If I thread this through here, you've got these little ridges here, which is nice to pull it through with. That's handy if you've got gloves on or you've got cold or wet fingers, so really easy to pull the strap through under load. And set your desired length, you just pull the strap over and clip it on there, and that holds it nice and securely. And you'll notice how the strap flattens out as I pull that under pressure. So that keeps this part of the strap down nice and low. I'll move on to the other little feature that's unique from Cedar Summit. This is real innovation and design here. It's called the strap keeper. Now, that's primarily designed to hold your strap in place so you don't get any loose bits flapping around. And that's kind of handy on a bike. You don't want that sticking into your leg. And the strap keeper also provides a few other features, which I'll go into shortly. So a cool feature of the Cedar Summit Stretch-Loc straps is you can join them together if you've got the same width. So I've got the 20mm one here. Maybe I've got two of these that are a bit short for the job I want to do. I can just grab another strap, feed it through, lock it off, and now my strap is longer again. So I can join that up again, and I've got a longer strap. You'll probably notice while I'm doing this that one of these is a bit wonky. Now, straight out of the packet, they're all bent up like that, and Cedar Summit recommend that you put them in boiling water for about a minute. I did this one earlier, straightened out somewhat, looks a bit better. Just to avoid those kinks. I'd also like to mention that you can't really join the small one to the big one. It's just not quite the right size because this little notch here is unique to each buckle. So you've got two different sizes there. What I'll do now is I'll take you around the shop and show you a few scenarios of how these Stretch-Loc straps work and how the strap keeper works. The Stretch-Loc straps are truly versatile. There's heaps of options for these things. I'm just going to take you through a few now that I've thought of. One scenario might be you've got a roof rack and you want to put your paddle for your kayak on there. You can strap it onto the roof rack, kayak paddle on there, or maybe your shovel on a four-wheel drive. Maybe your awning zip's busted on your four-wheel drive awning. You can get a bigger one and strap it around and hold it all in place. Use it on the trailer for tie downs, anywhere really. I'm going to show you a few scenarios. I've got a bike here. These are the perfect bikepacking accessory. I've got a nice bike here that I'll strap a water bottle onto. So you might have a water bottle cage there that you can use. Maybe you need a few more on your bikepacking setup. Maybe you need to attach your tube, so you could attach it up there, maybe up under the seat here, anywhere you want really using these straps. Just going to thread this 12mm one on, which is our lightest one, which is the bikepacker's choice. Just thread it through that hole on the strap keeper, pull it through nice and tight. If I just secure that, you can see how that sits in place when I'm not using it. That means it stays there. It's not going to fall off or go on the ground. You could use a couple of these if you've got a heavier load. Now, just slide that down a bit, put the bottle on, bring the strap around here through the buckle, and I'll just tension that up. And then I'm going to use the strap keeper to secure this strap. It's under tension there, so it's a bit tight, but you know it's going to be secure. Got those little ridges there to make it easier. Now, ideally, I would have set that up a little bit differently so it doesn't hit the tire, but you can see that bottle is really rigid and really secure there. You're going to be able to go over bumps. And that's not going anywhere. The keeper strap also doubles as a bit of protection for the paintwork on your bike, and it also provides a bit of grip so that thing doesn't go up and down. All right, another scenario is on your front forks here. I've already got one attached here. This is a 20mm strap. I've got that nice and secure. Ideally, I'd probably use two on a fork. And I've got the Cedar Summit Big River dry bag here. And I'm just going to thread it through This is the best dry bag for bikepacking adventures. It's got these little straps on the side to keep it secure. So they work really well together. Just gonna get the strap through there. Secure that off. And there you go. A nice option for more storage on your bike using a dry bag. Okay, another scenario might be in camp. You need some sunscreen or some hand sanitizer at quick access. So I'm just going to pop it up here on the pole, using the keeper strap once again. Thread it off, lock it off. It just stays there when I don't need it. Now I'm just going to reach in front here. And I've got some hand sanitizer. It's a bit of a heavy bottle of hand sanitizer, so I'm just going to get that buckle threaded to start with. Bring the bottle up there. Could use this sunscreen on the beach shelter. Lock it off and use the strap keeper there again. Okay, so that's nice and secure there for the pumping action. What I've shown you today is just a few scenarios with the smaller ones. The bigger ones are also quite versatile, right up to 750 mil, so you can use them for a swag on a roof rack or something like that. You can check out the diameter online and all the other little specs and details on our website at snowys.com.au, where you get low prices every day. If you like what you saw today and you want to see more videos, check them out over here, subscribe up there, or leave some comments down below.